the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In order to more worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask God for pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord
Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and the splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, in the covenant of your Christ, you never cease to gather to yourself from all nations a people growing together in unity through the Spirit. Grant, we pray, that your church, faithful to the mission entrusted to her, may continually go forward with the human family and always be the leaven and the soul of human society, to renew it in Christ and transform it into the family of God. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The Lord said to me, go buy yourself a linen loincloth, wear it on your loins, but do not put it in water. I bought the loincloth, as the Lord commanded, and put it on. A second time the word of the Lord came to me thus, take the loincloth which you bought and are wearing, and go now to the Parath. There, hide it in a cleft of the rock. Obedient to the Lord's command, I went to the Parath and buried the loincloth. After a long interval, the Lord said to me, go now to the Parath and fetch the loincloth, which I told you to hide there. Again, I went to the Parath, sought out and took the loincloth from the place where I had hid it. But it was rotted, good for nothing. Then the message came to me from the Lord. Thus says the Lord, so also I will allow the pride of Judah to rot, the great pride of Jerusalem. This wicked people, who refuse to obey my words, who walk in the stubbornness of their hearts, and follow strange gods to serve and adore them, shall be like this loincloth, which is good for nothing. For as close as the loincloth clings to a man's loins, so had I made the whole house of Israel and the whole house of Judah cling to me, says the Lord, to be my people, my renown, my praise, my beauty. But they did not listen. The word of the Lord. You have forgotten God gave you birth.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
You were unmindful of the rock that begot you. You forgot the God who gave you birth. When the Lord saw this, he was filled with loathing and anger toward his sons and daughters.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
I will hide my face from them, he said, and see what will then become of them. What a fickle race they are, sons with no loyalty in them. Since they have provoked me with their no God and angered me with their vain idols, I will provoke them with a no people, with a foolish nation, I will anger them.
The Lord be with you.
And
with a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus proposed a parable to the crowds. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, yet when it is full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches. He spoke to them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened. All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables to fulfill what had been said through the prophet. I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what has lain hidden in the foundation of the world. The Gospel of the Lord. Our Lord gives us 2 images of the role of the church in the world. We see that image of that leaven, that yeast that leavens the dough, and I know I preached about that just a few days ago when this was the Sunday reading. But that is what the Christian is called to be in the world, to be that leaven, to be that agent of change, of action, of reaction, that raises up those around us. That image of the mustard seed that becomes a huge plant is the church. The church is that tiny seed founded by our Lord and entrusted to that small group of apostles, imperfect men, rough men, not the most intelligent. That small seed of the church was planted with them, and it has been cultivated by the Holy Spirit for centuries, centuries, and generations. Until now it is a large bush that embraces all. Let's remember today that we are called to live in the branches of the church, to embrace all and to welcome all, and also to do so by being a leaven in the world, so that those that see the example of our faithfulness will be inspired to want to dwell in the branches of the tree of the church. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. receive with kindness the offerings we bring you, O Lord, and grant that your church, which came forth from the side of Christ as he slept on the cross, may ever draw her holiness from participation in this mystery, living by it always and responding worthily to her founder, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim: Holy,
holy, holy,
holy,
holy,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Robert our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be restored. an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you're truly present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I'm not able at this moment to receive you sacramentally, I ask that you spiritually enter into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Nourished by the sacrament of your Son, we implore you, Lord, to make fruitful the work of your church, for by it you constantly reveal the fullness of the mystery of salvation to the poor, whom you have called to an honored place in your eternal kingdom, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass has ended. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God.